Alrighty. My name is Chase, and so I was preparing for this little sermon and stuff. I couldn't think of anything to write about. So I went back and kind of looked at, you know, who are people in my life who've really influenced me. And I thought of my older brother, Cam, and you know, he's probably one of my greatest heroes. And I actually went to his MySpace profile for some reason, and I found this thing that he wrote. And he said, "One of my goals in life is to somehow leave a legacy. I want to impact the world in a positive way, and to the degree that my contribution will not be quickly forgotten. I don't understand how anyone can go through life not wanting to make a difference. Who wakes up and says, I want to be very average?" Now, my brother and I guess you could describe both of us as passionate people, because we have this great faith in a God who saved both of us and has given us a desire to show his word, to preach his word in our actions. And as my brother's goal in life is to leave some kind of impact, be able to have a legacy, it's a great goal, and he's doing it with all his heart. He goes out after everything, 100%. And God has laid another goal on my life, and it's a little bit different, but someday I would like to truly see America be saved, 100% of it. Today, to date, 85% of Americans say that they are saved. And I don't know if I necessarily agree with this, because it sure doesn't seem like that living in my high school and just going through life. I don't know if 85% of America is saved. But it is definitely my goal in life to see America be 100% saved. And if I were to go back about 5 years ago, you wouldn't know that that's my goal, because it wasn't. No more than 5 years ago, I was living in such a way that I was going the opposite direction of God. I was not following his will. And in fact, I was fed up with God. I remember specifically at a winter retreat, I was praying one night after service, and I was just sitting in my bunk praying, and I was like, you know what, God, I'm fed up with you. You've never been there for me. You've never loved me, and I just hate you. And after I prayed that, I went to bed, and you know, you're not supposed to go to bed angry, but I did. And the next night at service, the evangelist was up there speaking, and he just kind of stopped, and he was like, you know, there's some people here that need to hear about God's love and just what God has to say to them. And so I just kind of sat there, and I was waiting for people to walk around there saying stuff to each other. And then my friend Sarah came up to me, who I've been going to church with pretty much all my life, and she said, you know, Chase, I don't know why you need to hear this, but for some reason God wants me to let you know something, that he loves you, and he's never left your side, and he's always been there for you. And it was that point in my life that I was changed, and I finally began to believe that God did have a purpose for me, and he had a desire to be with me. And about a year later at the district youth camp, when Doug Green was here in 2006, he gave this really great message, and I went forward and prayed and stuff. And after service, I went to go talk to him just to thank him for being there. And as I was talking to him, I said, hold on, stop, what's your name? And I said, my name's Chase. And he goes, all right, Chase, tonight when you went up front and you prayed, I went and laid my hands on you and just started praying. And when I did, God spoke to me. And he said, you're going to lead a nation to Christ. And so it was then that I received my calling from God, that I'm going to do something great for him. And it was throughout the next couple of years that I finally began to realize that America is where I've been called. And I believe all you guys can agree with me that we've all been called to America, as it is a place that has turned so far from God that it needs him. We need a savior. If we truly want to see our friends and our family and the rest of America, we need to begin to put Christ as Lord. The average American Christian today is saved simply because they don't want to have to suffer from the penalty of their sins. They're not saved from their sins. They don't want to be saved for their sins. They don't want to break away from their sins. And the first time I heard this, that Christians want to be saved so they don't have to have a penalty, it hit me right in the heart. I was saved because I didn't want to go to hell. I wasn't saved because Jesus was my Lord. We call Jesus our Lord and Savior, but do we really mean that? Yes, we admit that he is our Savior, but who here has honestly ever lived with God as our true Lord? Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, then you will be saved. We get the saved part, but do we get the Lord part? It is only when we truly believe that Jesus is our Lord and Savior that we will begin to see God's work done in America. We see it in church camps. People go there and they're radically changed because they're able to admit, all right, I'm not perfect and God is. He can control my life and do something with me. And if we really want to begin seeing change in the people all around us, we need to realize that Jesus is Lord and allow him to take place, the place of honor in our lives. So in order to see America change, we need to begin letting Lord, our Lord Jesus, be the Lord of our lives and take control. Thank you.